Videos that seem innocent but have a terrifying backstory. Part 7. Just minutes after killing 3 people and injuring 260 others near the finish line of the Boston Marathon, bomber Dzhokhar Tsarnaev stopped by the local Whole Foods to grab some milk. In the 1980s, state treasurer Bud Dwyer was convicted of bribery, and during a public interview in office, he seemed normal and professed his innocence. But after being harassed by journalists, he pulled a gun out of an envelope and shot himself in the mouth on live TV. This TikTok shows a group of friends walking along the beach in Seattle when they stumbled upon a black suitcase sitting underneath the pier.
Wait, open it. Open it.
It's sweet.
It stinks, y'all.
It washed up. It's
Oh. It was later discovered the suitcase contained the mutilated body parts of Jessica Lewis and her boyfriend of 8 years, Austin Winter.
In 2005, Dylan Bryan had started filming himself while he slept. He's done this now every night for the last 6 months. Yeah, it seems like a real weird thing to do, but for Dylan, he needs to do it to prove to himself he's not who he thinks he could be. See, it all started for Dylan in 1992 when he was at school camp. On the second night, 2 kids were murdered in their sleep. But police pinned it on a guy that was in the woods that night. He'd been out of jail and was on parole. But no more than a year later, when he was at his year 10 camp, one of the teachers burnt to death in her cabin while she slept. Dylan started to think to himself that bad luck was following him. But Dylan was a champion wrestler and ended up going overseas with the wrestling team. During a sports competition in Paris, you guessed it, 3 people in his hotel were smothered to death during the night. Everyone was horrified, but Dylan noticed some scratches on his arm he couldn't explain. But he's married now and with a kid, but very confused that every night on the cameras he watches himself trying to break into his daughter's bedroom. He's just thankful he locks her bedroom door every night and gives the key to the neighbor.
These are 3 short horror stories. My wife woke me up last night to tell me that there was an intruder in her house. She was murdered by an intruder 2 years ago. I begin tucking my son into bed, and he tells me, "Dad, check for monsters under my bed." I look under the bed and I see him, another him. He is crying and tells me that there is a monster on his bed. Sarah was in her room when her mother yelled her name, so she started heading down. When she got to the stairs, her mother pulled her into her room, and she told her, "I heard it too." Then someone started knocking on the door and yelling, "Sarah," with her mother's voice.
Believe it or not, this is a well-documented, true story. In 1947, an American ship picked up a horrifying distress signal coming from an unidentified vessel. The first transmission was, "All officers, including the captain, are dead." The next transmission was, "The whole crew is dead." The last transmission was, "I die," and then silence. The Americans trace the signal back to a ship that's drifting off in the middle of the Indian Ocean. They quickly assemble a rescue team who boards the ship. They find the entire crew has perished in the exact same position. They are on their backs with their hands up as if fighting with some unseen force, and they look like this. There was no physical damage to the bodies or to the ship itself. However, even though it was 100 degrees outside, it was 40 degrees on the ship, and the bodies were rapidly decomposing. As soon as they tie up the ship to tow it in, it explodes, and then it sinks. To this day, no one knows what happened inside of that ship. Some say it was a chemical leak. Others aren't so sure.
Here are some photos taken right before disaster, part 3. Here is the last photo ever taken of Paul Walker. It shows him climbing into the car that eventually crashed, taking him and the driver's lives back in 2013. Craziest part is, Paul Walker wasn't even the one driving. The guy driving was a professional race car driver. And the saddest part is that all this happened at a charity event that Paul Walker was hosting. RIP. This photo was taken right before the Omaj bombing. The red car in this photograph right here contained a bomb that killed 29 people and injured some 220 others. Surprisingly, the man and child both survived, but the photographer didn't. This unsuspecting family snapped the last moments of Ayano's life. The 20-year-old student in the red threw herself over the railings outside of the Niagara Falls to her death. That's super sad. Pretty cool.
I just found the phone number to the deadliest hotel in Los Angeles, and this is why you should never call it. If this building looks familiar, you might recognize it from the series now streaming on Netflix, Crime Scene: The Vanishing at the Cecil Hotel, which details its dark history. During the 60s, there were at least 6 people who took their own life and countless murders that occurred in the hotel. and a satanic serial killer named Richard Ramirez lived there during his murder spree in 1985. Also, an Austrian serial killer named Jack Unterweger lived at the hotel in 1991, where he sought to copy the exact same crimes as Ramirez. The most notable of these strange events is the case of Elisa Lam, who went missing after checking into the hotel in 2013, making her the most recent victim in the Cecil Hotel's history. And while all this may sound horrifying, you guys know me, let's call that number.
The front desk of downtown Los Angeles' deadliest hotel.
Now, this message is pretty simple. Don't record yourself sleeping in the dark of night if you're not willing to know what's in it. In 2007, a woman in Richmond, Virginia was having trouble sleeping. She'd wake up in the morning feeling like she'd run a race. She finally saw a doctor who suggested that she record herself sleeping at night and send the videos through to him. So for the first few nights, she does this and just sends the videos off to the doctor. But two nights later, she's suddenly woken with this massive knock at the door. Police lights filling the night sky. She rushes to the front door and opens it. Two cops come barging past her with their guns drawn straight into the bedroom. The woman's terrified by this, but not as terrified as what the officers later tell her. See, in the few nights of recording that the doctor watched, a man entered her bedroom through the window. He injected her with a needle, then raped her. But in the last night's video before he left, he put a massive knife to her throat and said, "Tomorrow night's your last, I'm gonna gut you like a pig." After that night with all the police, the man never returned. But what's scary is they never found the man either.
Three more short horror stories. There was a picture in my phone of me sleeping, but I live alone. My sister says that my mom killed her. When I ask my mom, she says that I don't have a sister. My wife asked me why I was breathing so heavily, but I wasn't.
This is a story of the black birthmark. There was a 4-year-old boy who lived in a small village. He was born with a black birthmark on his forehead. As soon as he was old enough to talk, he told his family that he had lived before. He pointed to the birthmark on his forehead and told them a man murdered him with an axe. His parents then took him to the house where he claimed he lived before. He said he remembered his name, and it was the same name as the person who went missing from the village 4 years earlier. The boy remembered what the man who killed him looked like, and also his name. When he saw the man across the street, he walked right up to him and said, "I used to be your neighbor. We had a fight and then you killed me with an axe." The man turned white like a ghost. The boy said he knew where he buried his body. They went to a field where they found a pile of rocks. Under the rocks was a skeleton, with a wound in the exact same place as the birthmark.
Creepy photos that will give 99% of you chills, part 9. All of these self-portraits were created by the same artist who was diagnosed with Alzheimer's in 1996. From there, you can see how quickly the deterioration was. This is serial killer John Wayne Gacy, also known as the Killer Clown. He used to dress up as a clown and perform at kids' birthday parties. But when Gacy wasn't doing that, he was sexually assaulting and murdering over 30 young boys in just a 6-year span. A couple was enjoying their honeymoon, scuba diving in Queensland. This photo looks normal, until you see one of the divers dead in the background, which is Christina Watson. It was said that she went too deep under the water, and her husband was unable to save her due to the strong current. But witnesses say that Christina's husband was bear hugging her and pulling her under, and as her body sank, he swam in a different direction.